I'm coming from Greece, but I'm working the last 12 months in the Cyprus University of Technology. I'm a part of the research team in the Digital Heritage Research Lab. But I'm going to present a project that it was my PhD thesis for 8 years, I think, my lifetime project now, while I was living in a Greek island in Syros, in the Cyclades. The capital city is called Hermopolis and the system is called HERMeS. So you can see the connection there. Usually when I talk about the project and they say it's about the Greek island, everybody is having these nice images about Greece and Greek islands. And I have some really bad news for you. All Greek islands are not the same. I mean, they're not all with donkeys and the white and blue houses and the windmills and the, well, they have all the latest dressed in black, of course. But they have unique physiognomies. So this is Hermopolis. It's a very unique neoclassical city. It was built from scratch 200 years ago. There was nothing there but one small medieval settlement on the left up the hill, a Catholic community, and suddenly thousands of refugees came there with boats and trying to protect themselves, and they disembarked there and they start building this city in the beginning of the 19th century. So we have two different dogmas, Catholics and Orthodox, and two different cultures and two different economies packed in a really small place. And this diversity gave us today a really rich heritage. So as any city now in Greece, I think everywhere in the north, in the south Europe, and of course now maybe in the north Europe also, has this challenge. We are losing our heritage, especially in the small cities that they don't have so many tourists coming if the economy is not going really well. So you can see here in a classical building from the 1950s, and this picture in 80, you can see the difference. In 2002, the building is not there anymore, so it's a memory. We lost a very nice building with beautiful frescoes and paintings. And as this building, like this building, we have 150 more in Hermopolis. And I was a young engineer at that time, appointed in Syros Island, in Hermopolis. And I was researching about if we can have the best conservation plan. How can we save all these buildings, these historic buildings? So, a spoiler alert, because when you talk about the PhD thesis, you can talk forever. I will show you a video with everything, from the beginning to the end, in 2 minutes, and then I can maybe clarify some points. So let's go to video number one. touch with the radio, and while we are waiting to change computers, I will just tell you that I have with me my beautiful wife over there, sitting there. We have these origamis that when we have trouble sleeping at night, we are folding. It's handmade, and you can have one, but we leave it in the entrance. And and we can continue. So the challenge for HERMeS is, it's a huge challenge, it's to freeze time for these buildings. This is really difficult, of course, but also, not only freeze time, also to prioritize what buildings are we going to save first, because we cannot freeze time for all these buildings at the same time. We don't have the budget, we don't have the money. So this is a very easy question, building A, building B. Which building are you going to save if you have money to save only one of them? But you notice that the second one is near a schoolyard, it's near a school. So everybody uses some heritage activists, they say A, but everybody usually say B, because we need to save these kids, we don't want our kids to pass by this building. But if we add more variables, so this is what HERMeS is, it's an algorithm with a lot of variables, we can see that it's very complicated. It's not very easy to decide which building we are going to save first. And as you can see here, this is the map that is produced from HERMeS. It's a point system. It's an algorithm that now, today, is monitoring more than 1,000 historic buildings in this city. So it's working really well. We didn't lose any buildings from 2002. We are saving 4 to 6 buildings every year. And there is also a catch. The catch is that we cannot go and update our data all the time. It's very expensive because the city is changing, not very fast the last years of the economy, but it's changing. So in a point we decided to go public. We said, okay, let's ask people to update our database. So we saw the city as a big open museum, and we used Omeka, an open source software. We used open data, no copyrights, and we shared all the information with the people. And we start collecting stories, but most interesting is that it's not only updating the data. Pretty fast, everybody started reusing the data. So in education, in research, in tourism, in creativity, everybody is reusing data from HERMeS. And suddenly HERMeS was a project for raising awareness. And we saw that with community engagement, with schools going to communities, to local communities, and talk to people about the buildings. We saw creativity engagement, like festivals, installations, different parts of the cities. So if you need to find more information about HERMeS, you can just scan this leaflet, this origami with Liar, and there are a lot more information there. So a little bit about the future. I will conclude my presentation with those three slides. We are now installing signs in historic buildings. We have buildings who have signs with QR code at the beginning. And also, we have this another experience with, especially with older people in the city. They want to share stories, they want to share photographs, they want to share documents, they want to share books, they want to share intangible heritage about the city. And especially old people, that we are going to lose them in the next 10, 20 years. It's very important for us to go collect this information. So our next project with HERMeS is how to connect tangible and intangible heritage in the city. And let's face it, heritage sometimes can be really boring. This is why we are trying to make stories, why we are using technology so much, because our kids are coming and we need to pass this heritage to them. And they talk about technology, they talk this language, and we have to talk their language also. So we are trying to find ways with technology to connect tangible and intangible heritage. And this is a sneak preview. This is the first time we are showing this next step of HERMeS, and that's my last video on the slides. Thank you.